And now I will invite Aditi Singh ji to give the please inaugural lecture.
The theme of today's conference is towards civilizational and cultural synthesis within SAARC Asia. I think a lot of synthesis already exists. We share the flows of our rivers, the westerly winds do not start from our border, they sweep across Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. Monsoons come from Bangladesh right over the whole country. Our childhood stories are very much the same. Many of our historical heroes are common. Garlic belongs to all of us. Taj Mahal is for all of us. With so many challenges that we have in our society, a society which is divided in so many forms, in social hierarchies, economic hierarchies, political hierarchies. And wherever there are hierarchies, to that extent, democracy is denied. It becomes monopolistic to that extent. With all these challenges, a writer and an artist has lost to react to feel and express himself, to accept a challenge, and he put his own perception in it.
I'm glad to associate myself with this conference of writers from SAARC countries, which is undoubtedly a major cultural event. I congratulate the foundation of SAARC writers and literature and the moving force behind it, Srimati Ajit Kaur, for choosing to host the conference in India. The writers assembled here represent not only the seven SAARC countries, but the history, heritage, thoughts, emotions, dreams, aspirations of the peoples of this region. SAARC countries thus share a new destiny, negotiate the terrain of troubled times. These are times of unprecedented change. The old order heals place to the new. These are times when things fall apart. Values cherished for centuries are turned upside down by the strange configuration of circumstances. Our societies do experience new anxieties and nurse new hopes.
What was once a mere trickle is now a tide. Writers of the seven countries of South Asia are no longer condemned to labor in isolation. Today, they have succeeded in breaking barriers and crossing boundaries to build a culture of peace, understanding, and togetherness. It is a rare coming together of writers to celebrate the rich and vibrant heritage in a shared tapestry of culture. It is the day of the written word. We have writers from India, Pakistan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bangladesh, Bhutan, and Maldives. These conferences are not rituals. In fact, they have opened up new areas of experience. For some writers, it is cooperation. For others, a peace initiative. and for some, the emergence of a new literary sensibility.
The first conference I attended, and I think it is very wonderful, and it enriched my experiences, and I think it helps me to understand the otherness of the others.
I think these kind of conferences would help us to come in direct contact in person, and then provide us wonderful opportunity to share, to exchange views and experiences, to bring people more closer.
Conference is very great. This time, writers from Sudan and the Thailands also meet. It is the great pleasure to me.
For me, it's been very interesting to meet all the writers from different parts.
I was just talking to somebody who asked me that, do conferences really make any difference? And I was saying, yes, in certain terms they do. Obviously, they do not change the whole geopolitical scene, but they bring together writers, they bring together an exchange of ideas, and then those ideas begin to flow, people react to them in a creative way.
We are happy when we meet our counterparts here in India or from the SAARC countries. It's always not only inspiring, but I feel myself as a student of literature that I get more educated when I go back.
I will remember it throughout my life. It is such a wonderful occasion for me.
And it is a very good peace initiative, and to bring the writers of all the seven countries together.
Last time I was in Lahore, and this time we are meeting in New Delhi. And in Urdu, I can say, kisi guma pe tawakko zyada rakhte hain. Tawakko is the word, I don't know how to translate it in English. So, tawakko is the only word.
I think this conference is very significant because most of the writers have discussed the things about the future, about post-modern ideologies of the West, and how we should differentiate from those kinds of things, and how South Asia should be awakened.
ये डायलॉग की अपनी अहमियत है, तो जो गलतफहमियां कौमी सतह पर पैदा हो जाती हैं, इन्हीं ज़ाती मुलाकातों में और निजी मुलाकात खुद ब खुद हल हो जाती हैं, दूर हो जाती हैं।
Most of the problems that arise are often because we do not know each other. In our imagination, we think of the other. You know, we don't really know the other, and when we meet the other, we realize that he is not other. He is very much like ourselves.
The people from all the SAARC countries, the writers, thinkers, and philosophers, the poets are all here, and it's very heartening to see that everybody is focusing on the love, affection, and developing goodwill among nations and among the people.
And I think if we could have more of these type of forums, not only here but even in other countries, I think it is a wonderful project, and our governments, our individuals, and foundations, whoever can, should support, so that we could actually convert this into a movement, you know, not just as a single solitary foundation.
Oh, we are extremely grateful to the SAARC Foundation of Writers for organizing this excellent conference, which gives us an opportunity to meet, to discuss, to discover ourselves and the relationships that have always existed and will exist, but which we forget.
However, some writers have suggestions to improve these conferences further.
You know, it's a good beginning, and we have good writers here. But I think, you know, we should not end with a conference. We should have some translation project so that the most important of the writers are available in Indian translations, or at least translation into English, so that we can all share them, you know. So some such initiative is also necessary, but it can't be done like a conference. It has to be done with patience, with some deep tapasya, actually. For nearly 100 years, we have been Eurocentered. Every Indian writer knows another European writer, not another Indian writer. We take all our cues from Europe, even our political ideology, our intellectual analysis, everything is based on European notions. It is time we shift from Europe to Asia and be aware that there is a reality in the past as well as in the present, which I may call Asia. So we should talk about Asian cinema, Asian literature, Asian poetry, Asian theater, because Asian theater is much more vivid than European theater, because we have folk theater. We have such varieties. So to shift the whole consciousness, cultural consciousness from Europe to Asia is very important.
We are much aware about the European writing and the other part of the world, but we are quite ignorant about the literature created in the Southeast Asia. So SAARC is the right forum to understand and to see and to find out what is happening in the Nepal, what is happening in the Sri Lanka and the Pakistan also.
But to be very frank, I feel that so many delegates are invited that most of the time we are not even aware of the people who are sitting next to us. So there should be some closed sessions, separate sessions with four or five writers sitting together and sharing their views.
I feel more young writers should be included. So because the young people always have a bigger fire in them.
जब से ये कॉन्फ्रेंस शुरू हुई है मैं लगातार एक सपना देख रहा हूँ वो सपना ये है कि इस रीजन की एक कॉमन हिस्ट्री लिखी जानी चाहिए मेरा ख्याल ये है कि हिस्ट्री ने हमारे लिए बहुत सी प्रॉब्लम्स पैदा की हैं ज्योग्राफी ने नहीं चूँकि ज्योग्राफिकल रियलिटीज़ को फिजिकल रियलिटीज़ को अगर हम अपने सामने रखें तो फिर एक कॉमन हिस्ट्री भी लिखी जा और मेरा ख्याल ये है कि लिटरेचर की अपनी जो रिक्वायरमेंट्स होती हैं उसके जो अपने डिमांड्स होते हैं वो कम नहीं हैं लेकिन उससे आगे बढ़ के हमें ये भी सोचना चाहिए कि हम जिस दुनिया में रह रहे हैं वो चाहे जितनी बुरी दुनिया हो लेकिन वेदव्यास की दुनिया से बहरहाल डिफरेंट है वो तो आज की दुनिया के अपने कुछ टिपिकल उसके अपने रिक्वायरमेंट्स भी हैं अगर सारे अदीबों को ये एहसास हो जाए और मिलजुल कर अपना रेफरेंट वो आज के हिस्टोरिकल रियलिटीज़ को बनाएं तो उससे शायद एक बेहतर नतीजा निकल सकता है ये मेरा मानना है
For the writers of Pakistan and India, these conferences are very special. Haunted by the past, these writers yet find in them a new creative synergy.
हमारे देश में आया हूँ दोस्तों आपके नशेर और नगमा की महफिल न शायरी के लिए अगर तुम्हारी अना ही का है सवाल तो फिर चलो मैं हाथ बढ़ाता हूँ दोस्ती के लिए I extend my hand of friendship if you have any ego or something is stopping you.
जो टेंशन के ज़माने गुजरे हैं हिंदुस्तान और पाकिस्तान के दरमियान उस ज़माने में भी हमारे अदबी ताल्लुकात कभी मुनक़ते नहीं हुए
Even when there are problems and there is friction, the writers never cease to inspire people. Recently, one of the very senior Pakistani writers was asked, this is a lady writer, she was asked what did she think of the work of Quratulain Haider, you know, the great Urdu writer who is living in India. And this Pakistani writer said, don't talk to me about her work because she's an Indian. But people in Karachi and in Lahore and Islamabad, the common readers, they have not stopped reading Quratulain Haider. And there was a strong retaliation or reaction to this kind of comment. Recently, Intizar Hussain, who's one of the senior most Pakistani writers, he wrote a column on a Hindi novel, Kala Jal, which has just been published in Urdu. And he called it a masterpiece.
That writers of India and Pakistan and Farsakh that matter have never actually followed their politicians into the hatred or into the enmity which developed between our countries. We were always for friendly relations.
Politically, it is, you know, it is a reality. We can't negate it. We have different passports. We have different countries. But as a writer, I think that all the writers of the world, and especially subcontinent writers of different languages, of different, you know, with different cultural backgrounds, they are one.
We act as a writer and journalist, we can't do what the politician should do, but we can facilitate the people to sit and talk and argue.
In today's aggressive world, it's a very aggressive world. One has to be on guard and form alliances, form friendships, and become one, since entire history and culture, according to me, is now threatened at the hands of the quest of new imperialism.
Even now, painters on both sides continue to paint the pain of the partition.
When India turned 50 years old, I wanted to paint partition and my grandfather coming as a refugee with the Granth Sahib on his head. Because as a child, I knew that their links with, you know, Pakistan and being refugees are so strong. So I tried to paint a whole series of works based on that partition, and I also did Bhagat Singh and Udham Singh. And I do have a lot of Pakistani painter friends, and I was very, very proud. It was a very proud moment when Faiz Saab used 8 of the paintings, full page color, in Lotus in 1979, way back in 1979, 8 full pages of color. And just before his death, he asked for some new works also. And Lotus he was editing from Beirut. And so I formed a lot of links with Pakistani artists also.
Does the writer have a role to play in promoting peace and harmony in the SAARC region?
I think writers are the spokesmen of the human beings and humanity. So it is writers' duty to create peace and harmony and any other things among the people of this region. So I think the writer should write more and should go to the different conferences, should go to translate for their writings and try to reach the common masses of the region.
Writers can play a very important role as an cultural diplomat to bring the people more close to understand each other in spite of their own differences and variations. The creative people has always helped us unite, to be together with, in other words, to understand each other.
The role of a writer has not changed at all. This situation is, in essence, is not new. It's a very old situation, in new garb, it's an old wine in new bottles. So I think the writer has to play the same role which most of our Sufi Sikh poetry has done.
12 saal pehle Srimati Ajit Kaur ne jis ummeed ke sath ye sangathan shuru kiya ab wo andolan ki shakal le raha hai aur ye andolan शायद इस दौर में जो बहुत ही खुशगवार है, राजनीति के लोग खुले दिल दिमाग से बातें करने के लिए तैयार हो गए हैं। ऐसे खुशगवार मौसम में हम लोग माहौल बनाने का काम तो कर ही सकते हैं।
Certainly, I think writers can play a very major role molding public opinion.
I think the writers have a big role in bringing understanding between countries and between cultures, because although we are as a bloc, SAARC countries as a bloc, yet each of our countries are so different and each one has got such a rich cultural diversity and a rich history or heritage of literature, and yet we know so little about each other.
So writer has no place at all in the society, but anyhow, but he is addressing totally to a very minority of the society, because literature is not popular, and nobody is reading it. It's not the part of the daily habit of the people of our society. But it's still the writing, so writer has no place at all in the society, but anyhow. But he is addressing totally to a very minority of the society, because literature is not popular, and nobody is reading it. It's not the part of the daily habit of the people of our society. But still the writing is there, the books are there, and the writer is busy in creating the literature, and he is aware of his role in the society.
I think writers can do a lot about that, because it is a very influential power. Pen is a very powerful thing. So I think they can do a lot to create a understanding, better understanding, and also strengthening the relations between the countries.
मैं उस सच का क्या करूं जो जमीन पे बोला नहीं जा सकता, आसमान पे पढ़ा नहीं जा सकता, अखबार में छप नहीं सकता, और लोगों के सामने बोलो तो वो आपको वैशी और नाक बतंदेश कहते हैं.
Yes, the search for truth is unending. Every poet treads his or her own path to tell the tale differently. So it is with the poetry of Sark region.
एक युग था जब सबके सब पत्थर गाते थे, तब हमारे तुम्हारे जैसे इंसान इनके सामने गाते हुए शर्माते थे. आज इंसानों ने शर्माना, पत्थरों ने गाना छोड़ दिया है.
पुराने शहर की छत पर पूरे चांद की रात याद आ रही है, वर्षों पहले की जंगल की एक रात, जब चांद के नीचे जंगल पुकार रहे थे जंगल को, और 12 सिंगे पीछे छूट गए 12 सिंगों को, निर्जन मोड़ पर ऊंची झाड़ियों में ओझल होते हुए. क्या वे सब अभी तक बचे हुए हैं?
लपटों में घिरी मेरी प्रार्थना, तिलमिलाहट में भूलती अपने होने का, जीने का शिल्प मेरी कविता, आत्मा में भरे वात्या चक्र हमारी जागती रातें और विकल दिन. क्या कर पाए उस स्त्री के लिए जिसके साथ भीड़ ने किया पैशाचिक बलात्कार.
दिनों जब लगातार मनुष्यों के मारे जाने की खबर थी, कोई खता नहीं की हमने, तब भी बख्श दो ऐसा ही कुछ कहते लोग दिखते थे, मार दो कहते हुए लोगों के आगे.
पुरुष करंट में तब्दील हुई, स्त्री कुत्ते सड़क और माओं की हत्याओं से होती हुई भेड़ियों के संवाद तक जा पहुंची.
तू उदास है तर रज के उदास बोला दोस्त, तू उदास है तो रज के उदास बोला दोस्त, उदासियां चो ही तो हुंदी है यात्रा अगले पड़ावां दी. दर्द है कोई तो वहा दे सारा अखां चो, दर्द रह जाए अंदर तो बह जांदा है कालजे च किते.
पोएट्री विल बी रिटन डिस्पाइट फतवास एंड बैंस, पोएट्री विल डिफाई द गुलाग. It will ignore the censor's blue pencil and the fundamentalist's frown. Poetry will be written even as books are being burnt. After Gujarat, poetry will be written about Gujarat itself.
Raat diyan paudiyan chardi chardi saver kar dindi haan. Main har shaam रात दियां पौड़ियां चढ़दी चढ़दी सवेर कर दिंदी हां, सवेरे थकी टुटी जागती हां. संतापां दे लद्दे बोझल रथ वांग मैं अपने आप नूं घड़ीसदी नौकरी लई जांदी हां. नौकरी करन गई अनेक तोहमतां मत्थे ते लिखवा के वापस परतदी हां. मैं हर शाम रात दियां पौड़ियां चढ़दी चढ़दी पहली पौड़ी उत्ते मैनू मेरा मरिया बाप मिलता है. ओ अजे भी 38 वरियां दा ही है. हैरानी दी गल ता ए है कि उसकी दाढ़ी अजे भी काली है. लोग कहंदे हन वक्त बंदे ते की कुछ लिख जांदा है. मैं सोचदी हां हादसे कदे बुढ़े नहीं हुंदे.
बहुत मसरूफ रहता हूँ दिलों के सर्द मौसम पर, चमकती धूप का टुकड़ा बिछाने में, मोहब्बत के किसी वीरान साहिल पर, पड़ी है मौज छोटी सी उसे दरिया बनाने में.
Perhaps I'll wake up on some alien shore in the shimmer of an aluminium dawn to find the sea talking to itself and rummaging among the lines I have drawn, looking for something, a voyager perhaps, nailed as a thorn tree in whose loving hands these map lines of mine, somnambulant, will wake and pulse and turn to shoreline and sand.
वहशतें बढ़ती गईं इश्क के आजार के साथ, वहशतें बढ़ती गईं इश्क के आजार के साथ, अब तो हम बात भी करते नहीं गमखार के साथ. वहशतें बढ़ती गईं इश्क के आजार के साथ, अब तो हम बात भी करते नहीं गमखार के साथ. अब तो हम घर से निकलते हैं तो रख देते हैं, अब तो हम घर से निकलते हैं तो रख देते हैं ताक पर इज्जत सादात भी दस्तार के साथ. अब तो हम घर से निकलते हैं तो रख देते हैं ताक पर इज्जत सादात भी दस्तार के साथ. वहशतें बढ़ती गईं इश्क के आजार के साथ, अब तो हम बात भी करते नहीं गमखार के साथ. अब तो हम घर से निकलते हैं तो रख देते हैं ताक पर इज्जत सादात भी दस्तार के साथ. एक तो ख्वाब लिए फिरते हो गलियों गलियों, एक तो ख्वाब लिए फिरते हो गलियों गलियों, उस पे तकरार भी करते हो खरीदार के साथ. एक तो ख्वाब लिए फिरते हो गलियों गलियों, उस पे तकरार भी करते हो खरीदार के साथ. शहर का शहर ही वाइज हो तो क्या कीजिएगा, शहर का शहर ही वाइज हो तो क्या कीजिएगा, वरना हम रेन तो भिड़ जाते हैं दो चार के साथ. शहर का शहर ही वाइज हो तो क्या कीजिएगा, वरना हम रेन तो भिड़ जाते हैं दो चार के साथ. इस कदर खौफ है अब शहर की गलियों में के लोग, इस कदर खौफ है अब शहर की गलियों में के लोग, चाप सुनते हैं तो लग जाते हैं दीवार के साथ. इस कदर खौफ है अब शहर की गलियों में के लोग, चाप सुनते हैं तो लग जाते हैं दीवार के साथ. हमको उस अहद में तामीर का सौदा है जहां, हमको उस अहद में तामीर का सौदा है जहां, लोग मेमार को चुन देते हैं दीवार के साथ. बहुत शुक्रिया. में शिगाफ डालता है मेरा कलम नहीं उस दुज्द नीम शब का रफीक, आधी रात का चोर जो होता है. मेरा कलम नहीं उस दुज्द नीम शब का रफीक जो बेचराग घरों पर कमंद उछालता है. मेरा कलम नहीं मीजान ऐसे आदिल की मुनसिफ की जो अपने चेहरे पे दोहरा नकाब रखता है. मेरा कलम नहीं तस्बी उस मुबल्लिग की जो बंदगी का भी हरदम हिसाब रखता है. मेरा कलम तो अमानत है मेरे लोगों की, मेरा कलम तो अमानत है मेरे लोगों की, मेरा कलम तो अदालत मेरे जमीर की है. इसीलिए तो जो लिखा तपा के जान से लिखा, जबी तो लोच कमा का जुबान तीर की है. मैं कट गिरूं के सलामत रहूं यकीन है मुझे, मैं कट गिरूं के सलामत रहूं यकीन है मुझे, कि ये हिसारे सितम कोई तो गिराएगा, तमाम उम्र की ईजा नसीबियों की कसम, मेरे कलम का सफर रायगा न जाएगा। थैंक यू।
Sam Kaul, Ajit Kaur, the little lady behind this big show, a golden squirrel. Others even call her a tornado. And many wonder from where she gathers the energy to lead so large a movement.
29 years back, I started collecting writers from different languages who would come together in my house on the last Saturday of every month and would recite their poetry in Hindi or English translation. So 5 or 6 languages every week. Then built up our own cultural center, Academy of Fine Arts and Literature, and the whole thing moved to that 9 years back.
Oh, she is the very old good friend of mine, chief architect of this whole AFES.
I think she has done a very remarkable job. For organizing such a good conference is very you see, it's easy to collect and gather the people, but it's very difficult to organize a conference based or consisting on the writers, because every writer has his own ego.
There was a visionary, very rare among bureaucrats, I tell you very frankly and in total confidence. Her name was Meera Shankar. She called me and said, whatever you are doing is great, but why don't you collect all the writers on one platform and do it? I said, this is such a big job. The government should do it. She said, no, the government cannot do it, because culture is not a part of the SAARC constitution. SAARC constitution is called SAARC charter. Only an NGO can do it. And only a passionately committed person like you can do it. So I said, fine. And then the first conference was held in April 2000. And I didn't know the importance of my work till I got a letter from UNESCO, Paris, in January or February, before our conference, saying that they had declared our SAARC Writers Conference as the flagship event globally of the Year of Culture of Peace. Year 2000 was the Year of Culture of Peace. And they said, globally, this is the flagship event. Wow, I said, is it?
Ajit Kaur is a very active, bold lady.
Ajit Kaur bahut aham, yani fariza anjaam de rahi hai sir.
Ajit Kaur is, I think, driving force behind the academy. Is a very good leader. She has very good leadership, and I have very, very much appreciation towards her.
I sometimes wonder myself, and my daughter also doesn't want. She loves me too much. She wants to save me for herself. She says, "Don't do it. Don't overdo. Don't make so many phone calls. Don't do so much work." But I really feel that this is a crusade. It is a mission. And if I am true to the mission, I must go on doing it till every other country also picks up. Till a conference is organized on their own in a country like Maldives. A sleepy little country, and they say, Ajit, come, we are organizing a conference, bring all the writers. So far, the initiative has been emanating from here, and people come together, they give all their, but my dream is that one day, they will take over the movement, and I will go there as guest.
Well, I remember it as a very, as a tornado, as a volcano, as a lot of volcanic activity which has gone into making it possible. All
we, the writers assembled in New Delhi in the 11th SARC Writers Conference, organized by the Foundation of SARC Writers and Literature under the auspices of the Academy of Fine Arts and Literature, do hereby declare that, as heirs of a long pluralistic and dynamic civilizational heritage in the region, we feel literatures and arts in the SARC community.